Good morning, artists. And today for our drawing challenge, you are gonna draw something sweet. Now that something sweet can be a food, but it doesn't have to be. Draw me something sweet, or what do you think of when you think of the word sweets? You're gonna see what I come up with for mine right now.
When I think of the word sweets, there is nothing I think of more than Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. So that's what I'm going to go ahead and start drawing for today, is Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory. Be aware of your composition when you're drawing. Where are you putting things? How are you layering things? Are you starting out in pencil and making them completed, finished little drawings every single prompt for those days? I hope that you are. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, chocolate room. Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three. Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin. Traveling in the world of my creation, what we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it, want to change the world, there's nothing to it. No life I know to compare with pure imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be.
If you like the 1971 classic Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, then stick around, because you're about to discover 12 amazing facts you never knew about Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. The filmmakers got the Quaker Oats Company to invest $3 million to fund the movie based on an agreement to tie in the film's release with a new candy bar. The Oatmeal Company decided to name the new candy bar a Wonka Bar, which is why the movie's name was changed from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory to Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. But unfortunately for Quaker, there was an error in the formula that caused the bars to melt too easily, even as they were sitting on the shelf, so the Wonka bar was taken off the market soon after the film was released. Wonka's famous somersault was the main reason why Gene Wilder agreed to star in the movie. When Wilder was approached for the role, he said he would do it with one condition, that he would introduce Wonka by coming out with a limp and then falling forward into a somersault, because he thought it would represent Wonka's character perfectly, of being playful yet dangerous and unpredictable. The reaction on the kids' faces was real when they saw the chocolate garden, because none of the actors had seen the set yet. You might also be surprised to discover that Gene Wilder admitted a lot of the candy in the garden was actually real too. But the chocolate river and fountain were fake, and the substance was made up of 150,000 gallons of a mixture of water, chocolate, and cream. Having cream in the mixture made it spoil, and by the end of filming, the garden smelled terrible. The flower cup Gene Wilder was holding was also fake, and he chewed on it until the director yelled cut, and then he'd spit out the pieces before doing it again for another take. The Oompa Loompa behind the wheel of the riverboat actually thought he was steering it, but the director didn't have the heart to tell him the boat was really on a motorized track. For the tunnel scene, Gene Wilder filmed several takes of his monologue with varying degrees of emotion. And if you thought the one you saw in the movie was too intense, you'll be surprised to discover that the actors who played the kids admitted in the audio commentary that what you saw in the movie wasn't the scariest version he did. The young actors weren't warned that Gene Wilder was going to behave so crazily during the scene, and they were genuinely frightened by him and very relieved when they had finished filming the scene. Denise Nickerson, who played Violet, gave up chewing gum after the movie was over because her dentist found out that she had 13 cavities from chewing it constantly while filming. And the loads of blue makeup Nickerson wore during filming was so deeply ingrained in her pores that it resurfaced much later while she was at school. And it caused her face to turn blue while she was in math class, which she blames was the reason she didn't get any dates that year. The Oompa Loompa actors had a difficult time getting Nickerson out of the inventing room because for several takes they rolled her head into the wall since they had a hard time steering her straight. If you're curious what the flavored wallpaper really tasted like, the child actors admitted it just tasted like wallpaper and was very disgusting to lick over and over again. Another scene that had to be shot over and over again was when Julie Dawn Cole, who played Veruca, had to do 36 takes of her throwing boxes while singing, which she said was the most takes she'd ever done for a single shot over her entire film career. The foam used in the Wonka wash scene was made from fire extinguishers, but the foam was a skin irritant, and everyone reacted so badly to it that they all needed medical treatment for several days to recover. In the Wonka Vision Room, when Mike TV was being transmitted into the TV set, the particles in the air were created using hand-drawn cell animation, and they used green screen effects to make him look smaller in comparison to the other characters. The Oompa Loompa song in the Wonka Vision Room took 76 takes to get right because of all the cartwheels the actors had to do in the choreography. Willy Wonka's office was originally designed to look like a normal office, but when the director saw it, the chocolatier's workspace seemed very out of character because it was so plain after the whimsical nature of all the factory's other rooms. So the filmmakers came up with the idea to cut everything in half as an easy way to give the room a taste of Wonka's maniacal nature. And just like the tunnel scene, Peter Ostrom, who played Charlie, didn't know beforehand that Gene Wilder was going to yell at him in order to get his authentic reaction from Wonka's cruelty. The movie was filmed in Germany to keep American audiences from recognizing any of the exterior scenes. The outside of the factory was filmed at the Munich Gasworks, and the flyover footage during the elevator ride was from the village of Nordlingen. Roald Dahl, who wrote the book, disliked the movie so much that he refused to grant the film rights to his sequel book, Charlie and the Great Glass Elevator. He also said a remake of the original could never be made during his lifetime, and it wasn't until 15 years after the author's death that his estate approved the 2005 remake, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.